My purpose of my project was to create neural networks to analyze particle tracks detected by Lucid in space. Neural networks reform AI and machine learning used to solve various different problems. So, first, what is Lucid? Well, Lucid is a device in space consisting of 5 Timepix chips on the Tech Demo 1 satellite. So, the data we collect is in the format XYC, which is the X coordinate, Y coordinate, and the C, which is the energy value, as Dr. Campbell said before. Now, this can be converted into an image file that we can actually view as human. I mean, most of you can't obviously convert that into particles in your head. So, here we can see that there are several particles on the frame, and you can see each one of them is a particle. And most of them of these on the frame are repeaters. So, how to analyze these? Well, the idea of analyzing them is to classifying them, giving them names. So the first step is actually to cluster them, in other words, blob them so you can identify each individual particle in the frame, like so. Once you've identified them, the second step would be to actually calculate metrics or extract features from each of these particles. And we use a series of mathematics. Most of you have done GCSE, or right now in year 12, probably AS as well. So once you've extracted these features, they can then be used further on to classify the type of particle. So here, the classification we have is, as you can see, there's different classes for each particle, and you can see the shapes of each individual particle on the screen. Now, the current analysis algorithm we have was a simple series of if loops. And as you can see, that's not very accurate, because, as you can see, the image is actually 11 particles, whereas the analysis algorithm we used says it's less than 8. But that's we have to take that into account because it's not very accurate. And if you put it in greater than 11, it might classify a proton as a beta, and we don't want that. So we have to keep a limit on the 8. Now, this is why you can't use a simple deterministic algorithm. You have to use something like a neural network or other machine learning classifiers. The classification is not accurate, so therefore you have to use a deep neural network, is the one I researched. And the feature extraction, which is the second step, is also not very accurate. I haven't taken into account all the features in the work in the universe. So obviously we need to think about what we can do from the first step to get classified into the second step. Well, actually, we can actually use an image processing neural network, which is basically a convolutional neural network, instead of directly using the metrics with a deep neural network. We can go directly from 1 to 3 using convolutional neural networks. Now, neural networks, well, I researched loads, but obviously I couldn't test them all because it was a lot of difficulty in making them as well as testing them out. The first I researched was deep neural network. Now, this essentially maps a set of inputs to a set of outputs using a given set of weights. If any of you understand mathematical notation, well, you take a series of inputs, times it by the weights, sum them together, and you get an output. Now, that's a single node in that neural network. You take a series of these nodes and connect them together, and you get a different output every time on the red or orange dots. So this can basically be used to map the set of inputs to a set of outputs, and you'll see how this comes into play later. Well, this is one of the image neural network, which is basically, instead of taking metrics, we use the actual image. And that is then fed into a neural network later on, which will be green and the orange, to classify particles. The first one step is actually using this convolution, which is basically breaking down these images into smaller images. And then, obviously, there's 3 layers, which is the RGB values. And the subsampling layers are basically compressing the images so that they can be analyzed. Now, the third one was actually really difficult to test because as this one is blocks of neural networks, as in you're talking hundreds of neural networks connected together, and input data fed from between each one to the next one. And that's very difficult to do because it requires a lot of computing power, something I could not do on my normal school laptop. So the residual block is basically again, same thing as a neural network, but instead you have multiple neural networks. And the weight is essentially suggests that from x to the plus sign, that's basically one neural network, and you can keep on adding to make a residual network. So, the neural analysis. Well, the first step was actually generate the training data for a neural network, which was, so I created a web application, which basically means users like you can simply go on it, classify particles, and if you classify several of these go and set into a database, which can then be used to train a neural network. A neural network that I created was this one, and you can see the architecture of it. Obviously it's simpler, but yeah, so that's the basics of it and how it works. But once I trained the neural network, it was actually comparing the accuracy with other machine learning classifiers. And here you can see there's support vector machines, k-nearest neighbors, decision trees, or random forest. I obviously don't think any of you know that. I don't think I have time to explain it either. But. So the library uses TensorFlow for any programmers in the audience, and this is actually used by many corporations, including Google DeepMind. So the test results. Well, I plot an accuracy bar graph of each of these classifiers. The first three are neural networks, the last four are the machine learning classifiers I just mentioned. The first one is a deep neural network, second one is deep residual, as you can see. Second one is residual, and third one is the convolutional. And obviously the residual, I didn't have enough power, so that was not possible. So the first one and third one, the only plausible neural networks. So the GridPP was actually a major contribution to actually developing these neural networks, because I could test them out on a large scale. And on the red line, you can see that that's actually the 83% accuracy of the current classifier, of the current algorithm, and the neural network is actually on 93%, which was actually a 10% improvement, which is a stark difference. You're talking about 100,000 particles out of a million, which is a lot, to classify correctly. So, obviously it's a great PB, and the third one was actually plotting, using this same neural network to plot a map of each particle on the South Atlantic anomaly. So here you have protons, electrons, alpha particles, others, muons, and yeah. So each of these were actually, I've mapped these and then checked them with other research papers and found that they all corresponded as expected. Now, conclusion. Well, this neural network can then be integrated into software like Lucid Dashboard, like Tapas. And then even be possible applications for NASA and CERN. And the fact that not only can this be used for such softwares, it can also be used for projects like the Sun Angle project. Well, my reflection, why did I do this project? Well, first thing was I was inspired by Richard Feynman from the quote, "What I cannot create, I do not understand." Well, basically, I really wanted to combine the three fields of maths, computing, and physics into one project for my APQ, also because I was interested in it. And I didn't understand AI at the time. So I thought, why not create it and see how it would go? And I found, I create one simple one, and then decided I could use this for Lucid. I mean, this is a whole new thing I've learned. And it could be used for many more things. Later on, I found out about biochemistry applications. So this actually this opens up loads of different new fields that you can do, combining one subject with another. So that is why I was interested, and thank you for listening.